Hello, how are you? In this video, I bring you a video for those people who are musicians, DJs, or people who like to sing covers, a way of how to promote your music through Instagram stories or Facebook stories or WhatsApp states. For this, what we are going to need is the After Effects, Adobe After Effects, to be able to do the following. For those people who suddenly do not have the After Effects or their computer does not run the After Effects, but suddenly they run a slightly lighter editing program, I am going to try to make a more basic tutorial where I will leave you as the templates that I am using in the video so that you can mount them in your projects and edit them.
Como yo me siento cuando tú no estás, jamás en esta vida me he sentido así. Creo que perdí algo que no volverá.
Well, being here in the After Effects, the first thing we are going to do is open a new project. Then here in the workspace we are going to right-click in New Composition. We are going to modify the values of our composition. In width we are going to put 1080 and in height we are going to put 1920. Since the WhatsApp states are generally vertical, they are vertical videos. So that's why we are going to put these values. We are going to put the name that you want. And finally we are going to modify the duration of our project. In this case it will be only 20 seconds. Ready, once we have the composition, what we are going to do is add our files with which we are going to work. I have previously here some files already selected and I recommend that you also have some files with which you are going to work previously. Ready. If you do not want to work with an image, you can add a background video and apply the same parameters that you are going to see throughout this video. I am also going to add these two images that are the ones that correspond to what is Spotify and the YouTube platform. Well, the next thing we are going to do is scale our image to the size of our composition, and I am going to add the background. We are also going to scale it so that it fits the size of our composition. Well, the next thing we would do is pre-compose these two images. After having them selected, we are going to pre-compose. We make sure that the box is marked, transfer all the attributes to the new composition, and we put the name we want. Well, the next thing we are going to do is create a new solid. For this we are going to right click on the workspace and we are going to give it where it says new. Then in solid here you leave the attributes that you have and you put any color. Then we are going to go to the space where the effects are. If it does not appear to you, we are going to click where these two little arrows are together. We select it and we are going to see that the box that says effects and pre-settings appears here. Well, now the next thing we are going to do is look for the gradient effect of four colors and we are going to drag it to our solid. This is going to appear to us and we are going to modify the colors to our liking. Well, the next thing is to modify the gradient from the points that we are going to observe. There are four points. I am going to move only the ones below and I am going to move them as I like. Now we are going to press the T key. We select the solid and we press the T key here. The opacity values will appear to us. We are going to modify them according to our criteria. I am going to modify them in such a way that the background image is appreciated, but not so much. We can also select the solid and we are going to modify the gradient by moving the points to your liking. You move it to your liking. Well, and there we see that it is looking more or less good. Well, then we are going to apply an effect. We are going to go to our effects search engine and we are going to write the word die. We take the effect and drag it to our pre-composition. Then we are going to look for another effect called tone bar saturation and we apply it to our pre-composition. Then we are going to modify the values of the dye effect. We are going to modify the colors as they are adjusting to our background image. Here we see how it is combining. If we modify a color, it will look a little lighter, a little darker. There we are seeing. Then we select the other effect, tone and saturation, and we are going to lower the sample saturation to 75. Then we select our solid, and we are lowering the effect. Depending on the needs of your composition, in this case, I am going to leave it at 80. And with this, we would already have our background ready. Then we are going to drag to our project your cover song or instrumental that you want to promote. Now we create a new solid that we give it a new right click and solid we give it the same proportions. Then we go to our effect search engine and we are going to look for an effect that is called audio spectrum. We take it and drag it to our solid that we have just created. Now we select Our solid, we right click and we give it to change name. I am going to name the word. Spectrum, then here where it says audio layer, we are going to select our song and we are going to see that the effect is going to interact with our song and those bars are going to be played every time the song plays at the rhythm of the song. I make a clarification, and it is that at the time of recording this video, I did not give the option to record the sounds of my computer, and that is why the audio is not heard in this project. Now we are going to modify these values where it says maximum height, we write 700 and thickness, we put 10, and where it says visualization options, side and side, we are going to put side. Now what we are going to do is keep the left click where this box is, and we are going to see that a series of figures are displayed. We are going to take the one that says ellipse tool. Now we are going to press holding the control and alt keys, then we release it. And we are going to press the shift key, and we are going to a double click, and we are going to drag so that our circle is created uniformly. Here we see that the circle was left to me, it seems a little small, so I give it control Z, and we repeat the same process again, then we sync control and all, we keep them, then we release them, we sync chip, we click and drag so that our circle is created. Now we go to the control panel of effects, and where it says traced, we are going to select mask 1. Now we go to the layer of spectrum, we are going to deploy this little arrow so that these options are displayed, and we are going to increase the colado of the mask. This is done so that our waves of the spectrum do not go to cut. Something that I forgot to tell you here where it says frequency band, we are going to increase it to 100, and in the final frequency, already to your liking if you want. You can modify it, you can play with these values. For example, if we give it 300, we are going to see that our waves are no longer going to be in a straight line, but they are going to form a kind of undulation. If you see that suddenly the waves are being cut because we return to the colado of the mask and we increase it, then here where our effects are adjusted, we are going to change these colors, and we are going to put the 2 in white. Now what we are going to do is we are going to select the ellipse tool again, but without syncing anything this time, we are only going to sync the shift and right click so that the circle is made uniformly. And once created, we modify it either by dragging it with the clip or dragging it with our arrows. We lower the scale a little so that the line is parallel to the other circle. And up here we are going to increase the stroke. I am going to leave it at 18. And if suddenly it is not uniform with the other circle because with the arrows we are going down, well, now the same layer of shapes, we are going to give it control D. And a duplicate of the layer is going to be formed to this duplicated. We lower the scale more and we are accommodating it with the arrows that is well centered with respect to the layer of previous shapes. Now we are going to give the first layer of shapes right click and change the name. I am going to put a 1. And the other layer we are going to do the same. I am going to put a 2, and in the stroke of the last layer of shapes, the smallest one, we are going to put it in 4 or 5 now, and the layer of shapes are 1. We are going to sync it where it says add, and we are going to look for the effect to cut out strokes. Now we are going to stop at the beginning of our timeline and modify this option called end. We select it and drag it to the left until it is 0. Then we press this clock, the circle that is on the left of the end, and we go to the end of the timeline. Then we select the previously modified value again and drag it to the right until it is 100, and we are going to see that this effect is going to be generated. And finally, we go to the option that says it is called ellipse. We go to the option of line 1 and we modify where it says end of line, and we put the option of round end. What this effect is going to be is that At the tips of the bar, we'll have like a wave. Now we're going to create what the counter is. We're going to select the text tool. We click, but we do not write anything. Then we select. The text layer, we are going to unfold the arrow. We unfold where it says text and where it says text of origin. We are going to have the Alt key pressed, and we are going to select the clock what this is going to do here is going to appear to us this box where we are going to write the following expression. We are going to paste it. I will leave it in the description of the video so that they paste it. This is going to create this counter. And we are going to modify the scale. Then we put it in the center of the circle, and it is now that we already have our counter created. We are going to select everything related to the counter from the text layer. To the audio spectrum, then we are going to select the first file. We are going to have the Alt key. Pressed without releasing it, and we select as far as we want to select the redundancy is worth. Now what we are going to do is right click. We are going to give it in pre-compose. We activate the box to transfer all the attributes to the new composition, and we put the name that we want. Now we are going to apply some effects to this animation that we just made. We go to the effects search engine, and we are going to look for the gradient of four colors. We take it and drag it to our pre-composition. Now what we are going to do is bring the points closer, more or less like this, to our timer and modify the colors to our liking. I am going to modify it with some green colors. Since I want to combine it with the Spotify image and make it a good mix. Well, after having modified the colors, we are going to look for the effect called glow, and we drag it to our pre-composition. Then we modify the values of a glow dial. We drag it to the right until it is 100, and that's it. Then having selected our pre-composition, we are going to give it control of to make a duplicate, and we are going to silence any of the two so that we do not create a distortion in our final project. Now the pre-composition below, we are going to add an effect, and we are going to look for the effect called light burst 2.5. Now in the pre-composition, we are going to sync the T key for the opacity. We leave it at 90 or modify it to your liking, and then we sync the S key to modify the scale. This if we are going to leave it at 90. And we would already have our timer created. Now everything to finish is already a matter of organization. At least I am going to lower the timer. I am going to leave it at the bottom. I am going to modify the size, and to match the size of the timer, we are going to select the two precompositions, and we are going to modify either of the two the scale that will automatically modify the two scales at the same time. Then we are going to go to our project, and we are going to add the images of the platforms that you want to put in your story. For example, I'm going to add the YouTube platforms and Spotify. Remember that these images always have to be in PNG or without a background so that they fit well in the video so that there are no white edges, etc. Now I am going to silence one of the two files by syncing it in the little square, where the shape of the eye is this so that it does not get in the way. Now by syncing the S key, I am going to modify the scale, and everything is a matter of organization. And finally, it would only remain to add the text, the description of what you want to promote. We select the text tool, and right up here I am going to put the name of my song. Well, and I take advantage of this space by inviting you to my music channel, which I am going to leave in the description of the video and at the end of the video so that you can have a good time. You can also look for me on Spotify and in all digital stores. Also, in the next few weeks I will be uploading a method so that you can distribute your music in all digital stores. I want to mention this option that gives us After Effects. If you want your project to be all well-centered, well-organized, we are going to click here, and we are going to give it in proportional grid, and we are going to get this grid. I do not keep it active in this project, specifically since as it is a vertical project, the grid, as it does not fit well or for my taste, it is not good. Then I deactivate it. Well, then we continue modifying the description of our video. I am going to use this same letter that I have just created. I am going to select it, and I am going to give it Control D, and from this I am going to modify it. It seems more practical to me. I do it like this, then I download it and write the name of the artists. And we modify the scale with the key S. We accommodate it. And finally, the description would be missing where it says that this song is available in all digital stores. I do not know, you can put the type of description that suits your publication the most. Usually I put this on it. I give you a tip, and it is that you do not fill your image with so much text, since it is not very well seen and people can be disinterested in your publication already having all the elements that we need. Only is to organize sizes, organize positions, and our project would be complete. Good people, that would be all. I hope this tutorial has served you. Leave me in the comments any concerns. If I cannot answer it to another user who is watching the video, I can answer it. And so we are creating knowledge and community. I repeat again that I invite you to stop by my music channel and share my material if you like it. If you like this video, share it. Without more to say, I wish you a good day and see you in the next video.
Esta situación, yo no vuelvo a enamorarme. Muchas veces tuve ilusión, no hubo alguien para lastimarme. Ahora me hallo en la situación de que solo voy a quedarme. Creo que solo que estoy mejor donde nadie pueda